Hey everybody! So today I'm going to be showing you three different ways to dress up a side ponytail. Because we all know side ponytails, you know, they're just kind of there to keep the hair out of your face. But there's many ways that you can kind of cutify them. I'm kind of stealing that word from cute girls' hairstyles. But really, you can. And there's many different ways, but today I'm going to show you three. So if you would like to learn how to do it, stay tuned and I'll show you exactly what you need to do. Okay, so the first one is just to simply brush through the hair, make sure there's no tangles. I've already brushed through my hair. And you just want to sweep it over into a side, onto the side that you're going to do your ponytail. And then take an elastic, and it doesn't really matter what elastic. I think I'm going to be using, maybe this one today. But that really doesn't matter. And you're just going to secure it in a low, pretty loose ponytail. As many as you need to do. To make sure it's pretty tight, to make sure it's secure. And I do have really thick hair, so. Okay, so it should look something like this, kind of a really low ponytail. Now you're gonna take your fingers and then form like a little hole in your ponytail. And you're gonna take, with your other fingers, take the ponytail and flip it inside of itself. And then just take the two ends and just cinch it up a little bit. There you go. So it kind of adds just a pretty little, basically a twist to it. I wear this a lot. You can add a headband or a flower or something to match whatever you're wearing. But this is the first one, and I love it. It's just kind of simple. I wear it kind of for every day. It's perfect for school or just being home. So that's number one. Okay, number two. This one, you're just going to do a ponytail, and this one can be pretty tight against your head, or loose, or it doesn't really matter, but for this one, I like my hair against my head. And then you're going to take a section of hair from, like, the front to the side, but you want to make sure it's pretty long, so I'm actually going to take a little bit of hair from right here, make sure it's kind of like a long section. Good. And then just separate the rest of your hair out of the way. And now you're going to do just a regular 3-strand braid. So start braiding. And make it pretty loose. Because once we get about this far down the braid, we're going to tug on the ends. Just like that. So on both sides of the braid. And they don't have to be perfect because the point is to try to make it kind of messy looking. So braid a little bit more down. And then just tug. And it is helpful to do this before you reach the very end of your braid, because then once you try to go back up to the top, it's already braided all the way down, and it's kind of hard to go back to those strands. So just tug on it all the way down. And then once you get to the end, just care as much because they're going to be hidden. Okay. And then at this point, you could either secure it with an elastic or just leave it as is. I'm going to leave it. And you're going to take it and bring it up. And you're going to wrap it around your ponytail holder. And this one is kind of similar to the, then you're going to secure it with bobby pins, sorry. This one's kind of similar to, like, just wrapping it with normal hair. But I like doing it with a braid because I think it adds a little bit of a flair to it. So, just like that. And that is number two. Okay, the last way is kind of one that's a little bit difficult, but one that I love. I think it is so pretty. And this last one is one that you could wear to a formal event, just because it's a little bit dressier. But what you're gonna do is bring your hair to one side, and instead of just securing it off, you're gonna take your hair, divide it into two sections, and then you're going to begin something that's called an infinity braid or banana braid, or I don't really know what the official name is, but I've heard it called many different things. But anyway, here's the braid. You're going to, well, I'm going to call this section A and this section B. You're going to take a tiny little strand right from the outside of B, and you're going to take it up and over B, okay, and then under A. And then over A, and under B. Over B, and then when you have about this much hair left, you're gonna take some hair from wherever you are, kind of twist it into it, and then continue. So now we're ready to go under A, and then over A. Under B, and over B. Under A, I'm gonna do one more time adding hair, and then over A. Under B, and over B. Under A, and over A. Under B, and over B. And then I'm gonna keep it in the middle. So you kind of just did like a figure eight. Basically, if you keep that in mind, it kind of helps. Okay, so then just take an elastic that matches your hair and just secure it with that little strand in the back. And then kind of fix it up. And then go ahead and add some hairspray. And I'm just using Paul Mitchell Freeze and Shine Super Spray. Just whatever hairspray, you know, just something natural, whatever. And then now from here, I'm gonna actually curl my hair because it's more of an elegant, kind of fancy looking braid, I prefer to curl it. And I'm actually gonna be curling with my flat iron. So I'm gonna be taking my Chi flat iron, and I love this flat iron. I am telling you, it is amazing. It does the best curls. They look so amazing. So anyway, let's get back so you can see. I'm going to take a section of hair and then put my flattener over it, and then take the section and go up and over, and then I'm going to twist it like two times. until it's in the middle, like that. And then I'm just going to slowly bring it down. And you can put whatever products you want to in your hair. But it looks like that. Isn't that gorgeous? I just adore these curls. They're just so beautiful. They're just amazing. I just love them. So wrap it around. It's kind of harder with shorter sections, but twist. And then cool. If your hair is much longer than mine, you shouldn't really have a problem doing this. But, so basically, I'm just going to curl all over my ponytail, and then I'll see you at the end. So I went and I just curled my ponytail, and I had them all going in the same direction. I just really didn't feel like alternating the curls, but if you feel that you want to alternate the curls so it looks more natural, go ahead and do that. I just went one direction. That's funny. Okay, anyway, but I don't want them so defined, so I'm actually just going to take my paddle brush and just, I'm actually just going to brush through them. Just like that. And this just creates really a soft, kind of bouncy look. Add to your ponytail, and then just go ahead and finish it off with hairspray. You can kind of scrunch it if you would like. And there you go. I hope you guys enjoyed. Be sure to like and comment. Tell me which tell me which look you like the best, and I will see you guys next time. Bye!